It's GMT.
From broke2dope.com. We're on Urban 365 Radio and we're here with Earthgang.
We have Earthgang here with us.
Those who don't know who you are, can you just introduce yourselves?
Alright, cool. You go.
I ain't gonna do that.
Johnny Venus, you know me, man. We are Earthgang, man. From the southwest part of Atlanta, you know what I'm saying? Where all the Guada Grace came out of, man. We in here.
This British guy gave me mine apparently a couple of days ago, so it might have been more than a couple of days ago.
Really?
I just heard the podcast, so you know.
It just came. It's fun to say, man. I just wanted this to be something fun. I just wanted to say something fun to say. It's not like I grew up and like my mom was like, you know what? Mm-hmm. All the babies gonna call you Dr. Dad. Mm-hmm. And it's gonna be it.
Yeah.
It was like, it just, you know what I'm saying? It sprouted. When things sprout, you know what I'm saying? Latch on to the sprout stick. I got a million names though. I don't think either one of those rappers that like care about the rap name. Like most people call me by my gun.
Most people call me bruh.
But bruh, then second people call me government, people call me Dr. Dot, people call me Dr. Aqua, people call me, you know what I'm saying, all type of this stuff. Hey, it don't really matter.
Anything.
As long as you listen to the music and like it.
Yeah, so what's the music about? Tell me what you guys represent.
We represent, what you're scared to represent, man. We represent what you tuck away in your diary. And tuck away in your nightmares, man.
Represent freedom.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Just freedom is like my biggest thing. Freedom.
You guys just came up from South by Southwest. I know you got some crazy stories.
Tell me something. Okay. One story. I was kicking it with this dude I met out there named Gabe. We was kicking it. Like, he's this little Mexican guy. We was out there meeting chicks. I just happened to meet him out there. I watched Gabe beat the snot. Gabe was like, this is a cool ass little piece of little Mexican guy with a ponytail. Maybe 5'5".
He's like,
on his tallest day, Gabe 5'5". He's a little fella.
Gabe probably was a wrestler, man.
And Gabe beat the snot out of this dude. Like, it was a dude on South on the street, on 6th Street, actually, who was beating up his girlfriend, which is wrong. Gabe stepped in and was like, hey, man, you know what I'm saying? Take that out of here. What you doing? You know what I'm saying? I don't want to see that. Dude pushed Gabe. Gabe turned to, like, Apocalypto and just, like, climb this giant black guy and beat the snot out of him. It was pretty awesome.
That must have been funny to see.
Heck yeah, man. Oh, South by was crazy.
It was a lot of crazy stuff.
I was in a hit and run accident. F the guy. I wish I could cuss. F you, dude. I hit your car and I made it. And you didn't catch me.
And you are safe.
We ran.
You're safe. That's crazy.
Nobody was hurt, though.
Good. Man,
we was brawling.
Legend of LeBron continues.
Yeah. How was the performing out there? Like, how was the crowds? Was it any different from Atlanta?
More receptive.
Yeah.
Definitely.
People at a music festival want to hear music. People in Atlanta want to see strippers.
That's true.
So maybe if we had, like, big boobs and butts, maybe we
would have
seen
that. Man,
I feel it. Tell me about the Spillage Village, man.
That's the collective, that's the label, that's the squad, that's the homies, that's the family, that's the brotherhood, that's the fraternity, that's the insignia, that's the entity.
That's the
of course, Earthgang, then my man, G-I-D.
In the building.
Say something, bro. You here. He's here, actually.
He's here.
Hey. What's up, y'all?
G-I-D. We got Hollywood JB and Jordan Bryan, Sport X. We all work on each other's stuff. We all do vocals on each other's stuff, produce each other's stuff. It's a real, like, in-house operation.
Foolish.
We do a lot of work. We got all our, like, producing stuff are pretty specific to us. With. Oh, man.
Our interview is continuing. I have an interesting question I want to ask you guys.
No, you don't.
Yes. So, do you ever get the outcast comparison? And what do you feel about that?
Who is that?
No?
I never heard of those.
Right, it's just funny because you asked, that was the first time like, you asked us if we ever got that though. Like usually, you know what I'm saying, happens all the time. Like not all the time, but you know. Yeah. A lot of people just be like, you know, I don't know, man.
Feel like this, man.
Yeah, like
people can phrase what they
to whatever
with.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. What it is. People don't like venturing out of comfort zone, so they say, okay, you know what I'm saying? Like if you have never had nothing but apples your whole life and then you eat an orange, you're not gonna be like, dang, this is an orange. You're like, this is a weird apple.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Like that's it, you know what I'm saying? So
we have one last question. Broke to Dope, it used to be a money blog, but now we're kind of turning it to the music side.
Money blog?
Yeah. I was an econ major in school.
Money blog.
Spell man,
cool.
Hey.
Econ.
So.
Money blog.
You guys have a Broke to Dope moment?
No, we're still on the broke part.
Yeah.
Money blog. I just wanted to say.
You need to turn it back into the money blog.
Yeah, I would love
it. I need some money.
We don't have a two dope. I mean, I guess we're broke as dope as people, but not broke to like.
Everyone has
a
different
popped
meaning.
Out, we popped out dope.
Yeah, but I say that's bizarre.
Y'all dope to me.
Thank you. As far as like economically, fiscally dope. No.
Hey, babies like that. So, you guys want to introduce your song right now?
Yeah. Alright, coming to you live on your radio.
They got stuck.
Hope you're ready.
Brand new.
No. This is the F bomb actually. This is an older radio. Came off our EP Shallow Words for Toys.
Take it away.
Interview. I want to say thank you guys.
Thank you guys.
Anything you want to say?
We got a cool little project coming soon.
TMT.
So whatever you think of, you practice. You don't matter as much as your errors. Got a housewife or a bar wife. Why don't you watch your own life? I guess cause you got no life. Got a cool sign or a high five or a thumbs up. You're a dumb folk in my eyes, so don't try.